Right now, we're targeting 2% inflation. There are some who think it ought to be 2% deflation to maybe get our currency back under control a little more and stronger. And there are those who think, why aren't we just targeting zero inflation? Why should we have any inflation at all? So why should we have inflation? Well, the idea behind having inflation is that if you inflate the dollar, it encourages people to buy now. Why? Well, if the price is going to be more tomorrow, if it's going to be higher later, you may as well buy it now with the cheaper price, because you know it's going to go up in price. And that's the argument that's given. And is that true? Well, whether it's 2% higher next year or 2% less next year is probably not going to have an impact on your decision of whether to buy something or not. It might, but probably not. So why have the inflation? Why is it pushed so hard? Well, because there are two groups of people or organizations that are involved in the impact of inflation. One group are borrowers, and the other group are lenders. Well, borrowers love inflation. Why? They get the money today and they buy what they want. Then they pay it back later with inflated dollars, which means they're paying less money for it. And lenders hate inflation because they're loaning the money today at a certain rate, and when they get that money back later, they're getting money that's worth less because it's been inflated. So if borrowers like it, who is the greatest borrower in the world? The biggest organization to borrow money in the largest amount in the history of the world? I think we all know the answer. Is the U.S. government. The U.S. government owes more money than anybody's ever owed money in all history. So they love inflation. The more inflation, the better, because they get to pay back those treasuries with tax dollars they've collected, and those tax dollars are inflated and they pay back the older amount. So the U.S. government does not want the inflation to go away. They just want to keep it under control. What about deflation? So why doesn't the Fed target deflation so that what we see is our dollars actually become worth more? Well, they give the same argument in reverse. They say, if we have deflation, people will not buy today because they know it's going to be cheaper next year. If they can wait a year, they can get it for a lower price. Well, look, you have this situation right now where you have deflation in the price of computers. You buy a computer today for $1,000, and you wait a year, you're going to be able to buy that same computer, only better, for maybe $900. Well, that's a 10% deflation in 1 year. So are you going to decide not to buy the computer this time, this year, when you need it, because you might be able to get it for 10% less next year? Probably not. So it's kind of been proven that the idea of having a little bit of deflation doesn't seem to really impact purchasing decisions. On the other hand, it does make for the idea of encouraging loaning of money, lending. It would reduce interest rates dramatically. And so there's some positives associated with it. So the question is, inflation, deflation, or would it be best to just target zero inflation and have our money supply even be more stable and allow lenders and borrowers to be on an even foot?